हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्या प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सभी गौर भक्तवृंदा जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्या प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सभी गौर भक्तवृंदा हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपी कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय श्री राधे दुर्गा भगवान की जय
जय
हरे कृष्णा कृष्णा तरुण
हरे कृष्णा एवरीबॉडी
हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन
कृष्णा भगवान
हरे कृष्णा
सो हम लोग कैंटो 3 पढ़ रहे हैं चैप्टर 14 श्लोक 23 या चैप्टर 14 इज अबाउट अदिति या सो दिति and Aditi, yeah, and they are wives of which rishi? Aditi is wife of Kashyap rishi, yeah. So Kashyap rishi, hai, unki wife hai Aditi. Also, Aditi has also he is also wife. Aditi had all the demigods as her son, and then Aditi is also now coming and talking to. Kashyap Muni is in deep meditation, and but Aditi has come, and then she's talking about that, like all the other wives, they have children, and she wanted to have that too, right? And this is the story of like Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu, right? So Mahatma Vidur is asking. Maitreya Muni, yeah. So Mahatma Viduri asking Maitreya Muni, like just telling in summary of Lord Vara's appearance is okay, but he wants to really hear more about the whole and Lord Vara's avatar. So then he starts with Diti's story. That's what we are reading right now, right? So we'll read Diti's story, and then I think we'll get to Hiranyaksha. So let's read the shlok 23.
Yes. एषा घोरतमा वेला गोराणा घोर दर्शना चरन्ति यस्य भूतानि भूतेशानुचराणिः This particular time is most inauspicious because at this time the horrible looking ghost and constant companions of the Lord of the ghost are visible. Hare Krishna.
So can you guess who is speaking this?
Kashyap Muni is saying to
Diti, yeah? So Diti has come to Kashyap Muni, but Kashyap Muni is saying that this time is very inauspicious, yeah? Because the horrible looking ghosts and constant companions of the Lord of the ghosts are visible, okay? It says here, Bhutani Bhutesha Charani Hai. So, Sri Anilji?
एतस्यां साध्वी संध्यायां भगवान भूतवावनः परितो भूतपरिषद विर्वशेषानति भूतराट लॉर्ड शिवा द किंग ऑफ द घोस सिटिंग ऑन द बैक ऑफ हिज बुल कैरियर ट्रेवल्स एट दिस टाइम अकॉम्पनीड बाय घोस who follow him for their welfare. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So Lord Shiva, you know, he's above all the gunas, right? He's above, he's like Lord Vishnu, right? He's above tamogun, satogun, and rajogun, but he represents tamogun. And for the welfare of the ghosts and all that, okay, they approach Lord Shiva for their benefit, and Lord Shiva is very kind. So he travels at this time, at this particular time, all the ghosts are traveling, and that's what Kashyap Muni is saying. Yeah. Ajay?
Yeah. Shamshan Chakran Nil Dhul Dhrum Vikirna Vidyotaj Tajata Kalapah Basma Vaguntham Malurukma Deho Devastribhi Pashyati Dev Raste. Lord Shiva's body is reddish and he is unstained, but he is covered with the ashes. His hair is dusty from whirlwind dust of the burning crematorium. He is the younger brother of your husband, and he sees with three eyes. Hare Krishna.
So Kashyap Muni is describing kind of Lord Shiva, Lord Rudra, right? And he's saying he's a younger brother of your husband. So of course this is Diti. Diti's husband is Kashyap Muni. But Kashyap Muni is saying he's the younger brother. I mean, can you guess why he's saying that he's a younger brother?
Because they're both sons of Brahma.
Of Dakshina. No. So, yeah, okay. So Lord Shiva, right? So Lord Shiva is married to Sati, who is daughter of also King Daksha. Yeah, we know that story, right? Daksha, Raja ki, kai ladkiyan thi, and Sati is married to Lord Shiva. And Sati is a younger sister of Diti, also daughter of King Daksha. Yeah? So that's why, based on that, Kashyap Muni is saying he's your younger brother, so that's okay. Then he sees with his three eyes. We know that Lord Shiva has three eyes. And actually, there's some description here. Let's read that.
Lord Shiva is not an ordinary living entity, nor is he in the category of Vishnu or the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is far more powerful than any living entity up to the standard of Brahma, yet he is not on equal level with Vishnu. Since he is almost like Lord Vishnu, Shiva can see past, present, and future. One of his eyes is like the sun, another is like the moon, and his third eye, which is between his eyebrows, is like fire. He can generate fire from his middle eye, and he is able to vanquish any powerful living entity, including Brahma, yet he does not live pompously in a nice house, etc., nor does he possess any material properties, although he is master of the material world. He lives mostly in the crematorium, where dead bodies are burned, and the whirlwind dust of the crematorium is his bodily dress. Is unstained by material contamination. Kashyap took him as his younger brother because the youngest sister of Diti, Kashyap's wife, was married to Lord Shiva.
Right? It says that's why he was younger brother. And it says two things here, right? Lord Shiva is the master of the material world because he is married to Parvati, Sati, right? But he is unstained by the material contamination. He is above the material world. Okay? That's why it was important to see that. Tarun?
Na yasya loke svajana parova natyarto druto nota krishid vigraha Yaha Vayam Vratrera Yach Karana Pavidham माशहस्य ज बत भुक्त भोगाम. Translation: Lord Shiva regards no one as his relative, yet there is no one who is not connected with him. He does not regard anyone as very favorable or abominable. We respectfully worship the remnants of his foodstuff, and we vow to accept what is rejected by him. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. So that is Lord Shiva. Yeah. He is no one as his relative, but everybody is connected to him. Right. He is above the material contamination, but everybody is connected with him. Yeah. Hare Krishna, Rasiksha Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Nice to see you. I think it's a nice purport again. We'll read this, Ajay.
Kashyap informed his wife that just because Lord Shiva happened to be his brother-in-law, that should not encourage her in her offense towards him. Kashyap warned her that actually Lord Shiva is not connected with anyone, nor is anyone his enemy. Since he is one of the three controllers of the universal affairs, he is equal to everyone. His greatness is incomparable because he is the great devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is said that among all the devotees of the Personality of Godhead, Lord Shiva is the greatest. Thus, the remnants of foodstuff left by him are accepted by other devotees as Mahaprasad, or great spiritual foodstuff. Hare Krishna.
Ravi,
shall I continue?
The remnants of the foodstuffs offered to the Lord Krishna are called prasada. But when the same prasada is eaten by a great devotee like Lord Shiva, it is called Mahaprasada. Lord Shiva is so great that he does not care for the material prosperity, for which every one of us is so aware. Parvati, who is the powerful material nature personified, is under his full control as his wife, yet he does not use her even to build a residential house. He prefers to remain without shelter, and his great wife also agrees to live with him humbly. People in general worship goddesses Durga, the wife of Lord Shiva, for material prosperity, but Lord Shiva engages her in his service without material desire. He simply advises his great wife that all kinds of worship, the worship of Vishnu, is the highest, and the greater than that is the worship of great devotee or anything in relation with Vishnu. Hare Krishna.
All right, so Lord Shiva is being mentioned here, right? And we of course know a lot more about Lord Shiva, right? So the next look, Rasiksha Prabhu.
Yashan Vidya Charitam Manishino Grantya Vidya Patalam Vivat Savaha Nirastasya Samya Atishayo Api Yatsoyam Pisacharya Matit Gati Charati Gatihi Satam. Translation: Although no one in the material world is equal to or greater than Lord Shiva, and although his unpeachable character is followed by great souls to dismantle the mass of nations, he nevertheless remains as if he divine to give salvation to all devotees of the Lord. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. The important part is Lord Shiva giving salvation to all kind of devotees of the Lord, right? He's so kind, is what is being mentioned here. And actually, if you read this, Anil ji,
Lord Shiva's uncivilized, devilish characteristics are never abominable because he teaches the sincere devotees of the Lord how to practice detachment from material enjoyment. He is called Mahadev, or the greatest of all demigods, and no one is equal to or greater than him in the material world. He is almost equal with Lord Vishnu, although he always associates with Maya. Durga is above the reactionary state of the three modes of material nature, and although he is in charge of devilish characters in the mode of ignorance, he is not affected by such association. Hare Krishna.
Next, Ravi.
Asyanti yasya charita hi durbhagah swatat mana ratta yasya vidush samihitam yair vastra malya bharananu lepanehi shvabhojanam swatmata yop lalitam. Unfortunate foolish persons, not knowing that he is engaged in his own self laugh at him, such foolish persons engage in maintaining the body, which is eatable by dogs, with dresses, ornaments, garlands, and ornaments. Hare Krishna.
Right. Basically, what is being mentioned here is what Lord Shiva is depicting is that all these material decoration are not really important. The important part is the devotion. Demigods like Brahma also follow the religious rites observed by him. He is the controller of the material energy, which causes the creation of the material world. He is great, and therefore his devilish characteristics are simply imitation. Yeah? Saying like, just vidambanam, like yeah, vidambana hai ki how is Lord Mahadev is there, right? With like all the ashes and all those things. But he is really Mahadev. And you know, he says, Brahma Dayo Yat Kritu Setu Pala. Like all, even including Lord Brahmaji, they all follow the religious rites which are observed by Lord Shiva, and he's the controller of material energy, of course, right? And let's just read this. There's a lot of information here to Tarun. Tarun, can you read? Okay, Ajay. Can you hear me, Ajay? Are you able to hear me?